Fans, I'm Brad Nessler alongside my colleague Dick Vitale. We're here to call tonight's matchup between the Iona Gales and the Oregon Ducks. And here's a look at our star watch comparison. And there are the starting lineups for each team.
I'm going to keep my eye on the two kids at the small forward position. When you talk about key contributors, these guys are definitely at the top of the list for their respective teams.
Teams are ready to go, and we're ready for the tip. So here we go. Now trying to feed the low block. He strokes it. Perfectly executed. So Dick, so important now at the point. The point guard will set things up and the other four will go to work.
Well, you know what they're doing is a four around with a post guy on the interior, and they're trying to get that ball to the inside, but they're playing with four people on the exterior.
Both teams are looking to get something going here. On the left side, from three-point land, off the mark, cross court. Will take the shot, in and out. Dorsey handles the pass. They look to get it to the inside.
The athleticism in some of these kids, Brad, I'll tell you, it's incredible.
Cross court. There they come with a double team to stop it. He shoots the jumper. Scores it. Our three-prong attack tonight, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Brad Nessler with Dick Vitale and our friend EA Aaron Andrews checking in from the sideline. A momentary look from three-point land. Can't connect. On the dribble, gives it up. Top of the circle. I don't think that's the guy they want shooting that shot.
Hey, a few more of those, he may wind up on a bench.
Way out on top, controlling the ball. Tries for two, off the glass and no good. Gave it up, in the lane, jumper won't go. Brooks receives the ball. Looking to move it around the perimeter. Takes his jumper and come up short. Let's go courtside. What do you got for us, Aaron?
If you haven't noticed, the coaching staff really wants the team to get it going. They've been pleading with their players, get it going, speed up the pace. Up-tempo is what they're all about, and the coaching staff would like for them to get back on track.
Aaron Andrews, our sideline correspondent. I'll let you know that with an additional insight there. Williams picks up the foul. First personal foul. Oh, it looked like he had an easy basket coming up, but the defense commits the foul instead.
Great play there, Brad. He was able to foul him in order to prevent the easy basket. You know, with him in the lineup, they've done one of the toughest things to get in sports, experience. But remember, Brad, experience doesn't always come from being on the court. It comes in many different ways.
Throws go. They've got him right where they want him, Dick. for two. Can't get it to go. McGill handles the feed. Pushes it up. Goes up for two. He hits the shot.
High post screen.
Good defensive stance there against the spin move.
Well, the key is to beat him to the spot, and he did a great job. He anticipated that spin move.
Cross court. The chanting continues.
Who says there's no such thing as a home court advantage?
Brooks receives the ball.
Excellent jump shot right there.
Cross court. For the bucket. Buried it. Goes up. They get it to go. Cross court. He goes up with it.
Jumper didn't look pretty, I can tell you that. That baby was ugly. Coach looks on, focused, a lot of intensity, a lot of emotion.
Bust the jumper. Cross court. And it's blocked.
Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
Jumper off the mark. With the J, nails a sweet jumper. He fouled him. Well, if there is such a thing as a good foul, that was probably it.
Sure was, Brad. He fouled to prevent the easy basket.
Well, Dick, this young man's now in his second year.
He may be young, but if he's on the floor for this team, you know he's willing and able to contribute any way he can. He converts on that free throw line, and that's major.
They might have him in some trouble here, Dick.
He's trapped, Brad.
Great job of dribbling around that trap.
That trap didn't scare him, Brad.
Here's a double team. He looks for three. Off the mark. McGill receives the ball. Pushes it up. He shoots. It sticks. The Gales are getting some great opportunities to score when they get the ball in the high post.
Well, they manufactured that basket through the high post. I guarantee you that they work on it every day in practice.
Now looking for the pick.
Hey, it's important that the dribbler really turns that corner hard when he's using that ball screen.
He tries to knock down the three. Dick, he's just taking too many bad shots.
And I don't think he's done yet, Brad.
Number 10 takes the feed. Goes up with a shot. Nails the jumper. All right, let's check in third member of our team again. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Guys, if you haven't noticed, the coaches want the ball being pushed up the court. The tempo doesn't seem to be at a speed which is conducive to their style of play. Let's see how the players on the court react and make changes moving forward.
Aaron Andrews, always close to the action. How about the great job of getting to the basket right there, Dick?
I tell you, he was fearless right there. Did a great job taking it to the rack. And some great concentration to finish strong.
Cross court. Boucher getting after it and saves it. That's not a good pass. You know, Dick, this guy's really elevated his game today.
I tell you, as a coach, Pat, it's always nice to have a player surprisingly step up and perform better than expected. We'll have to keep a close eye on him moving forward.
The Ducks are on the run. Obvious foul. Well, it commits an intentional foul there to prevent the easy basket.
Well, it's a smart play, Brad, especially if you can afford to use a personal foul. I like his mentality. No easy basket.
The Ducks will step to the line for the first time. Sinks it. Charity strike. Traps in place, Dick. Well, this man's in trouble. 8 minutes left in the game clock. Tries for two. Goes. They'll work it around the arc. He attempts the three. Scores it. He draws a foul. Well, I don't know if there's such a thing as a good foul, but that might have been one right there, Dick.
Hey, Mr. Nessler, I like that type of play. He's saying to the defense, no easy baskets for you. We're going to force you to make shots.
To the line. Well, the arc looked good. He makes it. They have found their stroke at the stripe tonight, Dick.
This has always been an excellent free throw shooting bunch.
Man might be in a little bit of trouble here, Dick. Working around the perimeter. For two, he gets it to go. We take a look here at each team's tempo, Dick.
Hey, the key to this game is not just who will set the tempo, but who can control it throughout the game.
With a deep shot from outside, bust the J. About 7 minutes remaining on the game clock.
Dump it inside.
He shoots from the deep corner and come up short. Pushes it up. Arm and foul. Oh, it looked like he had an easy basket coming up, but the defense commits a foul instead.
Great play there, Brad. He was able to foul him in order to prevent the easy basket. If you want to know how aggressive a team is, you check to see how many times they go to the free throw line. That's a great indicator.
Well,
makes those free throws count. Let's go back on that campus. It's BMOC. Big man on campus, baby.
Smith handles the pass. They work the perimeter. Boy, terrible execution on offense.
Stop the ball. Somebody stop the ball.
Puts up the J. The missed shot.
Pushing that basketball.
He shoots from the corner. They get it to go. About 6 minutes remaining.
Block shot usually creates momentum and opportunity. There it is, Jam City.
Didn't look like anything was going to keep him from the basket there, Dick.
I tell you, he's really attacking the goal. He's going in fearless, and he's absolutely attacking the defense.
Launches away. Perfectly executed. Brooks receives the ball. They work it around the perimeter. Here's the three ball. Missed the jumper. Cassell handles the pass. About 5 minutes remaining. And nice looking jumper in the lane. On the dribble, gives it up. He wants a three.
Jumper didn't look pretty, I can tell you that. That baby was ugly.
On the elbow, they feed down to the low block. He fires away. He's taking a lot of bad shots out there, Dick.
I know, he's trying to catch fire, Brad, but it's just not there.
Launches the three. Busts the jumper. Works the perimeter.
Spacing's so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
For the bucket, knocks it down. Tries for two, too strong. He drains it. They'll bring it up. Goes right through the trap.
He wasn't afraid of that trap.
For two, he gets the bucket to fall. Top of the circle, they work it around the perimeter. Dumps it in. He gets that ball in the low block and immediately goes with a shot. Nope. On the outside. Goes up with it. Nails the sweet jumper. On the outside. Goes up for two. And we've got a change in possession here. The Ducks have been getting it done with a number of players here, Dick.
I tell you, it can really cause a defense fits and throw you off on offense when a team can play strong across all five positions on the floor.
Got him right where they want him, Dick. Inside. He attempts the jump shot. Jumper won't go. Gave it up. Bucket off the mark. Tries for two. It's good. We're at the 2-minute mark. Gliding in for the jam.
Sliding and gliding. Nobody rotated over. The defense moves so slowly.
Looking for a good shot. There's a double team waiting there. Pull up jumper, left side. Off the mark. Makes it. And the slam. That's taking it strong to the hoop, right, Dick?
That's a great job, Brad. Using his athleticism to get to the hoop and convert.
Looking for a good shot. He puts up the J. Missed it. Pushes it up. 1 minute left to go. Cross court. For two. Scorches the net. Dorsey handles the pass. From the top of the circle, scores it. Now they work it around the perimeter. Definitely a foul. Well, if there is such a thing as a good foul, that was probably it.
Sure was, Brad. He fouled to prevent the easy basket.
Dick, we all know how important it is to get to the free throw line.
Well, there's no doubt about it. I think it's such an unbelievable plus. It means you're playing aggressive basketball, you're playing attacking basketball, and you're creating all kinds of foul problems for the opponent.
Got them both.
Oh, he drained it. Nothing but nylon, NBN.
That trap could spell some trouble. Shot clock is dead. They're trying to make a statement. Well, it commits an intentional foul there to prevent the easy basket.
Well, that's a smart play, Brad, especially if you can afford to use a personal foul. I like his mentality. No easy baskets.
At the free throw line. He hits his first. It up. Takes the jumper. Off the mark. At the half, the Gales are behind by three. Oregon canned a lot of threes in the first half, Dick. Any chance of them cooling off in the second, you think?
Well, I'll tell you, Brad, unless they sit in a freezer during the halftime, I suspect they'll be just as hot from behind the arc in the second half.
Makes his way back into the ballgame. You think it's a good move, Dick?
Yeah, it's a move you've got to make, Brad. This guy holds this club together.
Gave it up. And there's a lazy pass. It's stolen away. Turnover. Will it turn into two the other way? Goes up for two. Gets it to go.
Hey, Brad, it's embarrassing to get scored on like that.
And they go into their motion offense, working with four around one here.
I tell you, the four around one, spacing's a key. You better have good spacing, and you better have people on the interior that can score with their back to the basket. If you got a big guy who can post up inside and who has passing ability, he's going to create opportunities for the guys on the perimeter.
Dorsey receives the ball. I don't know if there's such a thing as a good foul, but that might have been one right there, Dick.
Hey, Mr. Nesler, I like that type of play. He's saying to the defense, no easy baskets for you. We're going to force you to make shots.
A couple of free ones. Misses it. Seeing them all fall from the line tonight.
That's a crucial plus down the stretch, Brad.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. With a bucket. That's good.
That's a breakdown. That'll drive the coach bananas. Love you to lose your hair.
And the fans are going wild.
You're right.
He makes the block. He gets that ball in the low block and immediately goes with a shot. The missed shot. Moving it around the perimeter. He pulls up with a jumper. Nails the jumper. With the jumper, knocks it down. Isolated on the outside. They're working around the arc, looking for the open jumper. Takes his jumper. They get it to go. Dorsey receives the ball. Working it around the perimeter. Tries for two. Rims out. Momentary look from three-point land. And he goes with a spin.
I tell you, feel the defensive player on your hip going one way, and you spin back the other way.
Turnaround jumper. And come up short. The Ducks have been getting it done with a number of players here, Dick.
I tell you, it can really cause a defense fit and throw you off on offense when a team can play strong across all five positions on the floor.
Looking to move it around the perimeter for two. You betcha.
Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
He unloads. How can you not love this game and the hoopla and fanfare that goes along with it?
Wow, the energy is unbelievable in here.
Little two-man action. With the runner. Off the glass and no good. He drains the shot. across court. And again, they look to run.
Look at that spacing.
Goes up for two. Rims out. They'll work it around the arc.
Gotta think right now, gotta focus defensively.
Bust the J. The Gales got some good ball reversal there.
Hey, when your team can't get the ball moving like that, it can be really tough to guard. Do it often enough, and you can really wear the defense down.
The Gales are considered pretty balanced, I think, when talking about their style of play. Wouldn't you say, Dick?
They try to really get balanced in that they'll get some points with tempo by creating a little fast pace and then slow it down and executing their half-court set, getting high percentage shots.
They work it around the perimeter. He puts up the tray, gets the J to fall. He gets the bucket.
Up and inside.
He shoots from outside. Off the mark. Oh, and that's his fourth foul.
No, Brad. Coach doesn't want to have to limit his minutes.
Oh, it looked like he had an easy basket coming up, but the defense commits the foul instead.
Great play there, Brad. He was able to foul him in order to prevent the easy basket. Coaches love it when their team gets to the free throw line. It's an opportunity to put points on the board and potentially get the opponent in foul trouble.
Gotta make the freebies. Cross court. He tries the jumper. They got it. This guy can really score in a variety of ways down on the low block, Dick.
This guy's the total package. He can beat you in more ways than one, and that's scary for any defense.
Offensively, they get into their zone motion. Cross court. His shot blocked from behind.
He set him up nicely.
Bust the jumper. Dorsey receives the ball. He shoots the jumper. Off the mark. Cross court. So, Dick, so important now at the point. The point guard will set things up and the other four will go to work.
Well, you know what they're doing is a four around with a post guy on the interior. And they're trying to get that ball to the inside, but they're playing with four people on the exterior.
What are some of the things that up-tempo teams will look to do, Dick?
That's a good observation, Brad. Typically, up-tempo teams at the offensive end of the floor will crash the boards. Defensively, they'll often leak a guy out in transition in hopes of getting an easy basket.
Cross court. He goes up with it. Nope. Out on the wing. Tries for two. Makes the shot. They work the perimeter.
Nice hops.
On the dribble, gives it up. Benson fakes the shot. He puts up the three ball. Scorches the net with a J. And we're at the 8-minute mark. For two, he hits it. The Ducks can definitely be classified as an up-tempo team. Wouldn't you agree with that, Dick?
Hey, that's definitely their thing, Brad. They love to get players who look to attack offensively. Guys who aren't shy when it comes to taking shots early and often.
There's a high percentage shot.
Wow, what hops, baby, what hops.
They work it around the perimeter. Goes up for two. There was no doubt about that one. Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
With the J. Jumper won't go. We're at the 7-minute mark. Cassell handles the pass. He attempts the jump shot. Nails the J. Benson is seemingly at an emotional low point at this moment, Dick.
He's got to snap out of it. His team needs him.
Cassell receives the pass. Missed it. Out on the wing. Turnaround jumper.
I tell you, what a nice turnaround jump shot. Soft as velvet, fading away, impossible to block.
On the outside. 6 minutes left on the game clock. And the ball is saved. Great job. Ball's going to stay here. The long ball has really been falling for him, Dick.
Hey, something has gotten into these guys. They've been great from deep, Brad. They've been shooting the ball with confidence. This is great to watch. These guys are on fire.
So now let's see what they do with the inbounds play on the baseline. Outside. He takes a three.
Jumper didn't look pretty, I can tell you that. That baby was ugly.
On the left side. Looking for a good shot. Puts up the J. Nails a sweet jumper. From the top of the circle. He seems absolutely adverse to taking any good shots right now.
And with that, his teammates may be getting a little bit frustrated.
This one is shaping up to be a barn burner, Dick.
At this point in the game, clock management and execution are really important. The team that does these things well will win, I guarantee it.
The Ducks are going to try to hold on to the lead here, but should probably do so by playing in the half court as opposed to that up-tempo style, Dick.
Hey, knowing when to settle down in the half court is very important. When you have the lead and the clock is winding down, the offensive goal should be to have longer possessions.
Gave it up for two. The layup is good. Looking for a good shot. Gets the feed down low. Now the turnaround jumper.
I tell you, what a nice turnaround jump shot. Soft as velvet, fading away, impossible to block.
About 4 minutes remaining on the game clock. in the post. He pulls up with a jumper. Rims out. Now they work it around the perimeter. Goes up for two with the layup. In the post. He shoots the jumper. Missed the jumper.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. About 3 minutes remaining on the game clock. Dumps it in. Foul charge. Well, if there is such a thing as a good foul, that was probably it.
Sure was, Brad. He fouled to prevent the easy basket.
When he gets to the line, he's usually making them.
He really knows how to focus in on the target during free throws.
He misses the second shot. McGill handles the pass. Moving it around the perimeter. It rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
On the wing. He shoots from the elbow.
Hey, when are these guys going to be able to make a shot?
Isolated on the outside. They're working around the arc looking for the open jumper. Nice rejection. Gets the J to fall. The student body has got it going on. They look to be filled with rage and eager for a win.
The student body looks like they're having some fun out there.
He gets that ball in the low block and immediately goes with a shot. Can't connect. On the dribble, gives it up. J. Gave it up. He gets the rejection. On the dribble, gives it up. 1 minute left to go. From 3-point range. Nails the sweet jumper. We've got a break in the action, folks. Stay tuned for more ESPN coverage of the NCAA. Do you think they switch things around here for the moment, Dick?
I don't think so, but we'll wait and see, Brad.
It's a 10-point spread, Dick.
Yeah, but 10 points can't be spread too thin, Brad.
And come up short. He commits his final foul of the afternoon.
Hard-fought game, though.
Let's check out this jumper one more time. Stops the clock again. And the clock stopped for the foul. Well, this is now one of the better free throw shooting teams in college basketball, that's for sure.
Well, if you want to win those close games, Brad, you better make free throws. If you want to win championships, there's only one way. You better make free throws.
He makes the second shot. They look to get it to the inside. What kind of energy are we looking at after that timeout, Dick?
That's winning energy, baby. The team with the most energy and execution goes home with the big W.
The Gales running their zone offense here, Dick.
Hey, one thing that works well against zones is overloading the side. Overload a side and force the defense to shift out of their desired position.
And there's a look at the young freshman.
Hey, Brad, a first-year player starting his college career. Really exciting times in front of this young man.
Pushes it up. He goes for three. My goodness, Dick, have you ever seen such poor shooting before?
Wow, are they struggling, Brad? With a capital S. I don't think any of them are concentrating right now.
And now getting set up here in a four-round one.
I tell you, that big guy they have that can step out and go inside is really special. He gives you that flexibility, which makes the offense multifaceted.
Cage receives the ball, gave it up. And before we go anywhere else, let's check in and look at our players of the game.
It was great to see these two kids get after it here today. It always makes the game more interesting when you have competitors like this playing on opposing teams.